So I've got Visual Studio open. Let's go and take a look at some code. So I'm going to create my variable pi. 14159. I know there's more digits than that, but I've got to stop somewhere. And I'm storing that value in a variable, and then I can just print that value up on the screen using Control S to save here. I love using keyboard shortcuts. And why? Just trying to get that message to go away. There we go. And now that I'm here, run my code, and you will see that it displays, there's my number, 3.14159 on the screen. So again, just showing, yes, of course, I can store numbers and variables as well. And of course, once I'm storing numbers and variables, let me just comment out this code. Control KC, by the way, the keyboard shortcut for commenting out code. And now I can store a couple of numbers. First number equals 5, second number equals 6. And then I can add those numbers together, so I can do a print statement of first number plus second number. Because of course, the main reason we want to store numbers is because we're going to need to do math with them. So now I go ahead and I run this code using the up arrow to recall my last command, and it comes back and returns 11. You can change that to a multiply, and then you see 30. I can change that to a double exponent, which means to the power of. Save that code, rerun. And apparently, 5 to the power of 6 is 15,625. I admit that's beyond the capabilities of what I can do in my head. But that's why I like computers. They'll figure that stuff out for me. Computers are good at math. So this is a fairly common situation. But as I mentioned, one of the problems you will run into is, let's say I start asking the user to enter the values for the first and second number. So I say, hey, do an input statement and ask the user, please enter a number. And I'm going to take the number they enter and store it in that variable firstNum. And then I say, please enter another number. And I decide to store that in the variable secondNum. So all I've done is taken the value for firstNum and secondNum and taken it from the input statement. The rest of my code is the same. And yet, now when I run, I'm going to change this to a, this should probably give me an error. We'll try this. And it goes, enter number, I enter 5, and I enter number 6. And it goes, ah, unsupported operand type for the asterisk asterisk or the power command. It's like, it's got a string and a string. Well, what's Susan to the power of IBAC? So the problem is, it has two strings. I can demonstrate this by changing the to the power of symbol to a plus sign, because now you'll see the two strings concatenated together. So now if I run, and I'll just move this to the top of the screen so you can see it better, and I enter number 5 and the number 6, and you see it come back with 56. So this is the problem I was talking about, where the numbers are being treated as strings, because the input function always returns a string, even if that string contains a number. A little confusing, I know. So let's go in and fix that. So all we have to do is we have to go in here and say, treat this number as an integer. And treat this number as an integer, or take this variable and convert it to an integer. And now, when we enter 5 and 6, you can see it actually correctly does the math and returns 11. If you, and we change that to a float rather than an integer, the only difference is an integer is for whole numbers, a float can contain decimal numbers, so the only difference is going to be that when I enter the numbers, it shows 11.0, just a way of me recognizing it's a number that can contain decimals, a floating point number. So here I've used data type conversion to take a number that was stored in a string to treat it as a number. But there was one other scenario where we had to do data type conversion as well. So let's take a look at that one. So I'm going to comment out this code, Control KC, to do that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to say days in February. Help if I could type. February, if I could spell February as well, apparently, equals 28. And then I say print days in February, there we go, plus, and I want to concatenate that, total days in February. So sometimes we want to display a number inside a string, you know, on the screen. So now when I go and I run this, go down here, just clear the screen again with the CLS, and we see it again, it blows up. Take a look at that error message, says unsupported operand type. You have a plus sign is the operand, and you're trying to give it an integer and a string. So it's confused. Python doesn't know, is this two numbers I should add up with math, or two strings I should concatenate together? Because it has one number and one string. So we have to use the string function to convert days in February into a string data type. So now, when I go and run it, it comes back perfectly happily and comes back and says 28 total days in February. So now you have the ability to use numbers in your code, but do be prepared to start doing battle with some data type conversions. String, int, and float could become your new best friends.